Welcome to the Mountaineer Limited on the South Branch Valley Railroad. The date is Saturday, April 22, 1989, the day we rode the entire railroad from Green Spring, West Virginia, to Petersburg through the scenic valley of the South Branch of the Potomac River. Here the train is being pulled to the boarding area by XBNO GP9 number 6604 from a location a mile south of Green Spring, where it had been spotted overnight. The consist for our trip today included XBNO GP9 number 6135, an SBVR baggage car, two X Jersey Central open window coaches, an X Amtrak coach, an open air gondola, and SBVR caboose. At departure time, 9 a.m., our train backed north to the CSX junction at Green Spring in order to get all 52.4 miles for the serious mileage collectors. After this reverse move, we started south. The morning temperature was cool enough that some homes had wood fires burning, as evidenced by the chimney smoke. The first photo run-by location was at milepole 2.7 near Donaldson, along a gently flowing brook in a bucolic setting. As our train traveled south, we headed toward bridges 14 and 14A, crossing the south branch of the Potomac River. The South Branch Valley Railroad was donated to the West Virginia Railroad Maintenance Authority by the B&O on October 11, 1978, after several futile attempts in the early 1970s by the B&O to abandon this branch. Serious flooding by the South Branch River in 1985 destroyed much of the railroad and left debris throughout the valley. Here, as the train crosses Bridge 552, some of the damage caused by the flooding is still evident. On our ride, we passed many rustic farm scenes. This old farmhouse is next to Bridge 552. It's lunchtime. A box lunch was picked up at Romney. For 16 miles, the railroad is relatively inaccessible. This portion of our ride offered panoramic views of the valley and South Branch River. Bienno becomes especially inaccessible in the trough formed by the South Branch River. Besides the SBVR, the river offers the only other means of transportation through this rugged terrain. At the south end of the trough, the railroad crosses Sycamore Bridge, appropriately named for the numerous sycamore trees in the area. Agriculture is a major industry in this valley.
Double track now.
These stockyards are in Moorfield, the SBVR's home.
That's what's normally known as
out the left one, the forms that had built.
Oh.
Baker's Feed and Farm Supply. The last B&O department is working this line. Big discount right here. Right there he is. Hey, Bob.
Here are the South Branch Valley Railroad's engine house and yards. Just south of the SBVR yards is bridge number 571, where the railroad again crosses the South Branch. To south of Moorfield is the Rockingham Poultry Feed Mill, one of the larger customers for inbound loads. Here the railroad again clings to the river's edge as we head towards Petersburg. The day's final run-by was made at milepole 50 over Mill Creek in the Flat Valley a few miles north of Petersburg. The south end of the railroad is in Petersburg at the Allegheny Wood Products Company, where we disembarked for bus rides back to our cars at Green Spring. However, before we left, the SBVR crew made sure we got the very last inch of mileage.